In the final part of this three-part series on climate change, we will discuss the effects of climate change on the rivers and what one business's plan is to prevent major flooding again.
In the second part of this series, it was stated that with climate change, we can expect more flooding events from hurricanes and more rainfall otherwise in some areas. But Victorians who witnessed the flood of 98 or witnessed the devastation of Hurricane Harvey may wonder what this means for us. Mark Lenz, senior service hydrologist at the National Weather Service in New Braunfels, says not a lot is known about the effects climate change will have on our rivers, besides the fact that it would cause water levels to rise.
So far, there's been no definitive changes that we have noticed, but there could be, you know, with increased intensity or more frequent rainfall events, then we could notice, you know, could begin to notice that there would be increases in river flooding.
The Texas Zoo filled with water during Harvey due to the flooding of the Guadalupe River. The river crested at 31.25 feet, almost 2 feet above major flood stage, on August 31st of 2017. The crest from Harvey is the second highest in history here in Victoria, the first being the October 1998 flood. Zoo officials thought they were safe and took appropriate actions. However, those actions failed.
We have a berm built around the wall, around the zoo. And the berm was constructed some years back as a means to prevent flooding. So when Hurricane Harvey came in August of 2017, it sat and dumped over 20 inches of rain in certain parts of Texas. And all that water that came down the Guadalupe River accumulated. And when it hit the berm, we were fairly confident, based on the predictions of the river and what it was going to, you know, crest at, we were fairly confident that the zoo was going to be safe. That was not the case, and for a lot of different reasons, the water actually did breach the berm. And according to the FEMA maps, where we sit right now, we are in the floodway, and our berm is not sufficient enough to hold the water back if we have a major flooding event. But from my understanding and from what I've read, as we are starting to see the effects of climate change, we're going to start to see increases actually in large or major flooding events. We're going to start to see higher volumes of water, and that doesn't bode well for the zoo.
Now, the zoo is looking to protect itself from future flooding, but at a hefty price.
So we're looking at developing kind of like they're panels that get driven down into the ground, and they go very far into the earth. So that it becomes basically a waterproof barrier. A lot of places in, like, the refineries and big businesses along the water in New Orleans, in that whole area, they've used these as a way to, you know, keep water from, you know, coming into their plants or their complexes. And so it's the same system that we want to develop here. But that's going to be a really big project. That's over $1 million in order to protect the zoo.
While more research needs to be done on the effects of climate change on our nation's rivers, it's clear that climate change is affecting our local climate here in South Texas, and it is hard to ignore. Whether or not you decide to see it is up to you. For your hometown news, I'm meteorologist Alexandra Kent.
Alexandra, we had a big response on social media. What are you hearing from our users?
So one of the more positive comments that's kind of resonated with me is one person said, "We've all treated our planet badly. We can all do better." So I definitely kind of feel like that's the sentiment that we need to have when it comes to climate change, because the greenhouse gas bills and all that, that's going to come through Congress, but we can do things by ourselves as an individual to kind of make it easier.
All right. Thank you.